Hey, what's up, guys? My name's Aaron. There's an issue with eBay and Facebook pixels. I mean, in this modern day, with all the advanced digital marketing, it astonishes me that it's so difficult and hard to find an answer as to where to put a Facebook pixel and how into your eBay listings. So let's go through it real quick. So you can't use, let me show you, if you were to set up your pixel manually without a plugin, I mean, if you're using WordPress, whatever. If you were to install it on your site so you can use the no-code required pixel setup, you would just copy this code and put it in your listing. But this is JavaScript, so which means that eBay will flag that as active content and delete it. The only way around that, if you go to Facebook's developer, you'll see that you can use an image pixel. And this basically is literally, if you look at the size of this image tag, the height and the width is one pixel, because it is just literally a pixel for those of you who don't know what they use to perform their tracking. Okay, so anyways, so this is the link that you would want to copy and use. So I've put it over here and made it just a little bit more easy to read. This works, but for referencing and just cleaning up your code, it's best to actually have it as one line. I mean, that's just kind of standard, but for now, just so we can look at it, make it a little easier. You know what? Here, let me stop real quick. There are limitations on the Facebook pixel. You can do custom events, but you can't track purchases or anything like that. So you would use the pixel for page views, or you can make pixels for, see, I've got one of the genders for one of the shirts that we've got is unisex men's. And so if somebody looks at that, I can use that to build a custom audience based on the person who went and looked at that post or looked at that listing. I mean, so anyways, this is just to build custom audiences for your ads, because advertising for eBay right now on Facebook is almost like shooting in the dark compared to everything else you can do with every other website. So it's kind of a necessary thing. So anyways, back to this. You take your pixel ID, so you can just copy this here. I'm just going to input some numbers for you. Then your event code. The standard event codes, whenever you go to setup, you can view the standard event codes for certain things. And again, a lot of these things that you can't use because of the limitations of eBay. But again, I just use custom events because they're easy to look at to build custom audiences. And then I keep a spreadsheet of what each of them are so I can just reference them later whenever I'm installing new pixels. The events, you can name them anything you want to on this code here, and then Facebook will automatically log it and it will become a thing. So you don't have to worry about telling Facebook what each of these mean if you're just building simple custom audiences by page views. One thing that I do have in here that I think is pretty cool is you can put these image pixels in emails so you can see who's opened your email, like your thank you email, if you have thank you emails set up. And I'll show you how to do thank you emails and whatnot here in a little while later if you stick around. Let's get through this first part. So you take your event code. I'm going to name mine test event. And then I'm going to clean this up so it looks a little nicer and not so strange. And use some shortcut keys. Copy. Okay, and then we're going to go to your listing. Go to revise your listing, and then you'll go down to your description. Go to HTML, and what I do just for reference is I put it at the bottom. So, well, actually, that kind of, I mean, it's going to clean it up anyways. But as you can see, it's invisible. It has a style of display none. No one's going to see it. But just so you're aware, as soon as you go over to the standard thing, this renders that pixel. So every time that you load or edit this, it's going to register the pixel and it's going to track it on your Facebook analytics. So it's a best idea whenever you're creating a custom audience to exclude your own email from the audience, because you'll be picking up yourself while you are editing your listings. So just a little side note there. Now, what I use personally, I don't use just regular listings and whatnot. I use something called 3D sellers, which I like a lot better. For those of you who do use 3D sellers, I'll show you how to integrate pixels with 3D sellers. It's just jam-packed full of amazing things. With their free account, you get the thank you emails and the eBay listing designer. That's the two like main feature things that you get with it. I mean, which you'd have to pay anybody else to get these sorts of services. So I'm going to focus on what we just did with the listings and how to do it in 3D sellers. So the listings are pretty cool. You can just do about anything with them. If you customize it, your descriptions and featured products and whatnot are automatically put on display for you. It's pretty cool. You can customize just about anything. Get to your colors, custom colors, and all sorts of things. So anyways, so it's really, really best to make sure that you've got your pixels installed before you install your template in your listings. So if you're already a 3D seller and you have already installed your themes into your listings, I mean, there's a way around it. I mean, it'll take you a little bit, sit down with a cup of coffee and just rinse and repeat. But basically what you do is you go to your actual template here that would be in here, and you copy your description, go back to HTML, press Control A and delete it. Go back, paste, boom. Your original description is back. Go back, install the pixel that you want, and save. And for just a little bit, while you're doing this, you're not going to have your templates anymore for a second. So try and do it on some downtime during your store's busiest hours is not a good idea. So next is the emails. Now, and it's just a regular email platform, everybody knows that you can just put HTML or an image or anything in there that you want to. So let's say, I mean, even if you aren't a 3D sellers platform person and you're using some other email server where you can just input pictures, well, their messaging system is about the same. Let me show you. It's pretty simple. You just go back to this link here and you just want only the URL. That's all that you want. So you would, so copy and what I like to do is I like to put them at the very, very beginning. That way I just know where they are, because if I have them anywhere else, I'm going to be guessing because they're invisible. There's one on here right now. In fact, if you want to look at the ones that you already have on your email with 3D sellers, if right click where they are and press inspect, it's working some Firefox and Chrome and all that. Kind of lost it. Let me do it again. Inspect, you're looking at this box right here. Here's what you just clicked on. Find a span. This is it here, but you're looking for a span. And it's going to have that Facebook URL in it. And then you can see what your event code is and whatnot in there. So what you would do is you would just click and have it at the beginning and just boom, paste. There's your event. Press OK. Now you've got custom pixels, so you know who's opened your email. That can come in handy for who's active on their emails. So you want to maybe send out some ads for a new email list to promote some different sales. And so now you use a custom audience for the people that you know are actively opening your emails. And so that would definitely come in handy as a marketing tool to know who's opened. Anyways, so that would pretty much conclude it. Links to everything in here that I've shown you is in the description. I highly recommend 3D sellers if at least just for the free stuff, because I mean that's just kind of necessary with today's standards. Speaking of necessary, we should ask eBay for some pixel integration so badly. Anyways, I hope to help you guys out. Have a good day, guys.